school girl has the same effect as when it's sold to an automobile thief or a horse thief. Congress has passed a law putting $2 a tax on whiskey, and they expect to realize $300 million. That means that the American people have got to buy and drink 150 million gallons a year. They have put $5 a barrel tax on beer. That means the people have got to buy and drink 32 million barrels of beer a year. It doesn't take a lawyer to figure out that if you do that, you take that much money out of the legitimate channels of trade, you spend that much less for food and clothes and boots and shoes and education and automobiles. Oh, America didn't need repeal. She needed repentance. She didn't need wrong. She needed righteousness. We don't need jags. We need Jesus. We don't need more Brock. We need more of God.
In Winona Lake, Indiana, not far from the tabernacle that bears his name, is his house. A veritable museum of tokens of esteem from the mightiest and the least. On the wall of his study are signed portraits of the great men of his time. Taft, Wilson, Harding, Coolidge, Hoover, Teddy Roosevelt, Cecil B. DeMille, General Pershing, the Mayo brothers. And the room is filled with mementos from some of the thousands of people who shed tears at his departure from their town. A clock from the employees of Wanamaker's in Philadelphia. Trophies and loving cups, one given him by the chauffeurs of Scranton, Pennsylvania. Another clock from the Pittsburgh Pirates. Gifts given to Billy Sunday from the people whose language he spoke, the people of the country he loved.
Billy Sunday's funeral service was held in the great Moody Church in Chicago. It seats 4,000 people and was crowded in the afternoon, but all through the day, a rainy day, people came walking through to look into the face of the man who had meant so much to them, to their families.